Hola amigos y amigas, bienvenidos a RBC Internacional. Mi nombre es Mara Carranza y hoy estoy aquí gracias a la invitación de los administradores de este canal y su fundador Ricardo Belmont Casinelli. Voy a traducir el programa del presidente de México, Andrés Manuel López Obrador, del español a inglés. Hello friends, my name is Mara Carranza from AMLO Vision. Welcome to RBC International. And I am here today because I was invited by the administrators of this channel and also by the founder of this channel, Ricardo Belmont Casinelli of Peru. And I am going to be translating the morning conference of the Mexican President, Andrés Manuel López Obrador, into English so that the English-speaking public can also have a chance at hearing what's going on around the world. Thank you very much, and I hope you enjoy this program.
Y ahora vamos a pedirle al secretario de Relaciones Exteriores, Marcelo Ebrard, que informe
Now we're going to ask the Director of Foreign Relations, Marcelo Ebrard, to explain what happened with the situation with Bolivia and Evo Morales, the president in exile.
Asilo al presidente Evo Morales.
Con su permiso, señor presidente.
And he said, with your permission, Mr. President.
Bueno, como ya ustedes tienen la información, el día de ayer recibimos la comunicación por parte de Evo Morales de aceptar.
So he said, as you know, yesterday we received the communication from President Evo Morales that he was accepting our invitation to let him to
el ofrecimiento de asilo
to accept the offer of asylum
que México ofreció.
That Mexico offered.
A raíz de ello se instruyó por parte del señor presidente.
So based on that, we were instructed by Mr. President
que se trasladara una aeronave de nuestra fuerza aérea.
So he told us that we needed to take a military airplane to go pick him up.
Para pasar literalmente a Bolivia.
So that we could literally pass to Bolivia.
Por Evo Morales. Bueno,
To go get Evo Morales.
Serían muchos los detalles, pero me voy a referir a los puntos principales.
So he said there was a lot of details, but I'm going to stick to the main points.
Ha sido como un periplo por diferentes espacios y decisiones políticas.
He said there was a lot of situations, spatial, different politics and stuff that happened.
En primer lugar, la ruta que se eligió fue a través de Lima, Perú.
So first of all, the route we decided to take was through Lima, Peru.
Se pidió autorización al gobierno de ese país.
And we asked for permission or authorization from that country.
Se nos otorgó.
And they granted it.
La aeronave bajó en Lima, Perú como primer punto de contacto.
So the airplane landed in Lima, Peru as its first point of contact.
Ahí tuvo que esperar porque para poder conseguir las autorizaciones en Bolivia.
So there we had to stop and wait to get the authorizations from Bolivia.
Correspondientes, ya se imaginarán ustedes el problema.
That corresponded, and you can imagine the problem.
en virtud de que están en medio de un proceso político muy complejo.
Because it was a very complex political situation.
Y entonces no está claro quién decide qué.
And so at that point it was unclear who would decide what.
Al final del día se otorgó el permiso por las autoridades competentes en Bolivia.
So at the end of the day we got the permission from the competent authorities in Bolivia.
Y se le dio instrucción a la aeronave que viajara. Despegaron de Lima.
So they gave instruction that the airplane can travel and depart from Lima.
Y cuando llegaron al espacio aéreo de Bolivia, les dijeron que no, que ese permiso ya no era válido.
So once we got into Bolivian air space, they told us, no, that permission is no longer valid.
Oye, pero ya estoy aquí en vuelo.
He said, but wait, we're already in flight.
Sí, pero no, no pueden pasar al espacio aéreo.
Yes, but you can't go into our airspace.
Entonces hubo que retornar a Lima.
So then we had to return to Lima, or Lima.
Ahí en Lima, esperar varias horas.
And there in Lima, we waited several hours.
Para poder conseguir la autorización que finalmente, con la valiosa intervención de nuestra embajadora.
So finally, we were able to get authorization by the intervention of our hardworking
del subsecretario de América Latina,
of the subsecretary of Latin America,
y del de la voz, finalmente el comando de la Fuerza Aérea.
So finally, the commander of Air Force, of the Air Force,
fue el que otorgó el permiso.
Was the one that granted the permission.
Para que pudiéramos ir.
So that we would be able to go.
Lo cual también dice quién tiene el poder ahorita en Bolivia.
So this is what lets you know who has the power right now in Bolivia.
Entonces, pasó la aeronave, llegó al aeropuerto donde estaba esperando los Evo Morales.
So we took off and we arrived at the airport where Evo Morales was waiting for us.
Y la ruta que teníamos prevista para retornar pues era la misma.
And the route we had planned on returning through was the same one.
Regresar por Lima, después sale a aguas internacionales y de...
So we planned to go through Lima and then go to international waters.
De ahí hasta México.
And then get to Mexico.
Pero ya casi por salir, estoy hablando hora de México, ya alrededor de las 7:30 de la noche.
So at around 7:30 p.m., just as about we were about to leave,
el gobierno del Perú, por vía de su canciller,
the government of Peru, via their concierge,
me comunicó que por valoraciones políticas se suspendía ese permiso para bajar en Lima.
So due to some political issues, they had to suspend that permission that we had to land in Lima.
A recargar combustible.
So that we could refuel.
Y retornar a México.
And return to Mexico.
Entonces, eso fue muy difícil, muy tenso, porque en...
And that was very difficult, very tense.
En el aeropuerto donde estaba Evo Morales en ese momento.
Because at the airport where Evo Morales was at that moment.
Pues ya había una situación difícil por dos razones. Primero,
it was a difficult situation for two reasons. First of all,
porque los seguidores o simpatizantes de él...
Because his followers, the sympathizers,
estaban en torno al aeropuerto,
had surrounded the airport.
Y al interior del aeropuerto había elementos de las Fuerzas Armadas de Bolivia.
And on the inside of the perimeter and at the airport were the armed forces of the Bolivians.
Bien. Entonces fueron un periodo de los de mayor tensión.
So this was a period of major tension.
Para nosotros.
For us.
Finalmente hubo que conseguir una ruta, un plan B.
So finally we had to take another route, plan B.
Pero lo que conseguíamos es plan B. Se pudo haber dado una situación muy difícil en el propio aeropuerto. Ya están.
But what we had as plan B could have given us a very difficult situation now at the airport.
Nuevo Morales a bordo de la aeronave de la Fuerza Aérea de México.
Because now we had Evo Morales on the Mexican Air Force plane.
Fue el peor momento, por supuesto.
That was the most difficult moment, of course.
Hablamos con Paraguay.
And so then we spoke with Paraguay.
Yo establecí contacto con el canciller que amablemente me atendió.
And I spoke to the concierge there that spoke to me.
Nos ayudó mucho el presidente electo de Argentina, le agradezco profundamente su.
And the elected president of Argentina helped us very much, and I'm very grateful.
Su apoyo y su gentileza.
For his support and his cordial behavior.
Porque él habló con el presidente de Paraguay también por su lado.
Because he spoke to the president of Paraguay on his side.
Y el canciller me dijo, no tenemos inconveniente.
And the concierge told me, okay, it's not inconvenient for us.
En que vengan ustedes a la Asunción, vuela el avión a la Asunción.
So you may fly your airplane to Asunción.
Aquí recargue combustible.
And here you can refuel.
Combustible. Y permanezcan las horas que sean necesarias.
And you may remain the order, the time that is necessary.
Ustedes hacen su trámite de autorización de espacio aéreo porque.
So that you can get your permissions for airspace travel.
Entendemos la circunstancia en la que están, puede convertirse en una tragedia lo que está.
Because the circumstances in which you are could become a tragedy.
Pasando. Entonces, amablemente y le agradecemos mucho al gobierno del Paraguay.
So, very amiably, and we appreciate very much the behavior of the government of Paraguay.
Entonces nos concedieron esta autorización, pero ya se imagina.
And they conceded to this authorization, but you can imagine.
¿Saben ustedes que cada autorización requiere hablarle a alguien?
That every authorization required us to talk to someone.
La dirección correspondiente, mandarle los datos.
And we had to get the directions and then send them the data.
Sacar el permiso.
Obtain the permit.
Llámeme ahorita en un momentito.
And they would say, call me in a few minutes or in a moment.
Eso es normal en todos los países.
And of course, that's normal in all the countries.
Entonces, eso prolongó todavía más.
So this prolonged it even more.
El general que viene a cargo de la aeronave es un agente excepcional.
So the person that, the general that was in charge of the naval unit was an exceptional person.
Estamos muy agradecidos con la Fuerza Aérea de México, siempre su profesionalismo impresionante, una sangre fría.
And we are very grateful to him, and he's got very cool head.
Fuera de serie y también habilidad.
And he also has great abilities.
Para poder dialogar con la contraparte. En el,
so that he could speak with the counterparts and dialogue.
Ese momento tan complicado, ¿no?
At a very complicated moment.
Volvió a intervenir la embajadora y finalmente logró.
And so the ambassador intervened again.
Que de nuevo la Fuerza Aérea de Bolivia nos permitiera salir porque ya no.
So that the Bolivian they could allow us to exit the Bolivian airspace.
Se van a permitir salir. Ahora sí que por un milimétrico espacio.
So there, by a millimeter of space,
se dio la salida.
They gave us the exit. from Bolivia.
Ya saliendo de Bolivia.
And since after flying out of Bolivia,
llegaron a Asunción.
We arrived at Asunción.
De ahí volver a hablar con Perú y decir, bueno, no.
And then again we had to talk to Peru.
Vamos a bajar a recargar combustible, pero déjenos cruzar su espacio aéreo.
And we told them, okay, we won't stop and get refuel, but can you let us go through your air space?
De regreso.
In order to return.
Entonces hicieron las consultas correspondientes y me habló el canciller y me dijo.
And so they corresponded with who was appropriate, and then they called me and let me know through the concierge.
Sí, estamos de acuerdo con eso.
Yes, we are in agreement with that.
Pasen por nuestro espacio aéreo.
You may pass through our airspace.
Luego, hablar con el canciller del Ecuador.
And then we had to speak with the concierge of Ecuador.
Para decir, oye, si necesitamos recargar combustible, podemos bajar en Guayaquil.
And we asked, if we need to get more fuel, can we stop in Guayaquil?
Consultas, sí, sí pueden bajar en Guayaquil. Para.
And then they said, yes, you can stop in Guayaquil.
Recargar combustible, sí.
In order to refuel if you require it.
Es necesario para ustedes. Se tramitaron los permisos luego a.
And so we got the permits, and so then.
Volvemos a hablar a Bolivia y nos dicen, no, fíjate que ya no te vamos a dar permiso.
And so we called Bolivia again and they said, no, we're not going to give you permission.
De volver a cruzar el espacio aéreo de Bolivia.
To cross again through the airspace in Bolivia.
Es decir, para volar de Asunción hacia Perú.
So then to fly from Asunción to Peru.
Tienes que cruzar el espacio aéreo de Bolivia.
You would have to cross the airspace in Bolivia.
Ya no, y además ya es muy tarde.
And so then they said, no, it's too late now.
Porque allá van horas adelante.
Because their time is a few hours ahead.
Entonces, como no se puede cruzar Bolivia, ¿cuáles serían las alternativas?
So since we could not cross Bolivia, what was our alternative?
Entonces, amablemente, el embajador de Brasil.
So very amiably, the ambassador from Brazil
nos dice en La Paz.
He let us know in La Paz.
Nos dice, si quieren, yo les ayudo.
If you would like, I will help you.
Después hablamos con el embajador.
And then later we'll speak with the ambassador.
De México en Brasil.
Of Mexico and Brazil.
El embajador Piña. Y en la madrugada consiguieron milagrosamente casi.
And then in the very early mornings of the hour, very fortunately, they got.
Y también agradecemos al gobierno de Brasil.
They got a hold of the governor of Brazil, and we also appreciate the help from the governor of Brazil.
El permiso para poder volar en el espacio aéreo de Brasil.
So he gave us the permission to go from the area of Brazil.
En la línea fronteriza entre Bolivia y Brasil.
Between the frontal area between Bolivia and Brazil.
Y de ahí salir a Perú.
And then from there go to Peru.
Esa era la ruta. Y de Perú.
And that was the route. And then from Peru.
Cruzar el espacio aéreo de Ecuador, ya no bajar.
We had to cross the airspace in Ecuador and we could no longer go down
Guayaquil y seguir
to Guayaquil.
Ir hasta la Ciudad de México porque la autonomía.
So we then had to go to the City of Mexico because the autonomía
de ese avión son aproximadamente 11 horas de vuelo.
Because the airplane cannot get approximately 11 hours of flight.
Entonces, como teníamos ya recargado con combustible.
And since we had already refueled,
dijimos, pues ya no bajemos.
So we decided not to stop or go down.
Porque está siendo muy complicado el permiso.
Because these permits are getting very complicated.
Bueno, dado el permiso entonces de Brasil.
So then, since we had received the permission from Brazil,
la autorización de Perú y la autorización de Ecuador,
the authorization from Peru and the authorization from Ecuador.
al fin despegó el avión al filo de las 2 de la madrugada hora de México.
So about 2 in the morning, time of Mexico, finally the airplane took off.
Va volando desde entonces.
And so then it was flying at that time.
Última vicisitud que nos refieren.
And then the last thing that they referred us.
Es que hubo que rodear Ecuador, porque ya estando.
Then we had to go around Ecuador.
En vuelo.
Because once we were in flight.
Les dijeron que no les permitían sobrevolar el espacio aéreo.
They said they were not going to allow us to go through their airspace.
Y que lo iban a revisar. Eso ya en la madrugada.
And that they would review that. That was early in the morning hours.
Entonces hubo que rodear para entrar a aguas internacionales.
So then we had to go around them to go into over international waters.
Y poder en aguas internacionales continuar el vuelo.
And then once we were over international waters, we could continue with our flight.
En estos momentos están en eso.
So at these moments they were at that, going at that.
Eso va a provocar otro retraso aproximadamente un poco más de una hora hasta dos.
So that was going to cause us to have another delay for approximately an hour.
Tenemos información ahora vía la fuerza aérea.
And that's the last information we had when I saw the Air Force people.
Ya ese vuelo en su mayor parte transcurrirá.
And now that flight in its majority will continue to go forth.
Pues en aguas internacionales.
Over international waters.
Así que no esperaría yo más contratiempos.
So I would not expect any more delays.
Es como un viaje por la política latinoamericana, cómo se toman las decisiones.
It was a trip that had to do with political Latin situations and how these situations occurred.
Y los riesgos que se corren.
And the risks that you run.
Bueno, estamos esperando entonces que a partir de las 11 de la mañana.
So we are now waiting and we expect that around 11 a.m.
11 y media de la mañana podamos estar recibiendo a Evo Morales en México.
That we will be receiving Evo Morales in Mexico.
Conforme a lo que establece el artículo 11 de la Constitución.
According to what the Article 11 of our Constitution permits.
Y las leyes correspondientes en México.
And the corresponding laws in Mexico.
El propósito de ese artículo.
The purpose of that article.
Y de los ordenamientos legales.
And the legal ordinances
es proteger, ofrecer protección,
is to offer protection and to protect
a la vida y a la integridad,
the life and the integrity
de aquellas personas que sean objeto de persecución política,
of those persons that are objects of political persecution.
Así lo dice la Constitución.
That is how the Constitution says it.
Y así lo ha ejercido México durante décadas.
And that is how Mexico has exercised it during for decades.
Bueno, desde el siglo XIX. O sea, ya serían siglos.
So that's how I could say maybe even centuries.
Entonces, esperamos que a esa hora aproximadamente esté por acá.
So we expect that approximately around that time he will be here.
Ya él dará su versión de los hechos, no le corresponde al gobierno de México dar la versión de por qué tomó la.
And so then he will give his version of what happened, and it doesn't correspond to Mexico to say.
Las decisiones que tomó.
Regarding the decisions he made.
Esas le corresponden a él.
That belongs to him.
En su esfera, sus posiciones, sus convicciones.
Regarding his positions, his convictions.
Sus proyectos.
His projects.
La única obligación que tendrá en México, por supuesto, pues es respeto.
The only obligation Mexico will have then is to
respetar la Constitución y las leyes de México.
To follow the Constitution and the laws of Mexico.
Ese sería el informe, señor presidente.
And that is the full information, Mr. President. Okay, so anyway, I just wanted to let you guys know just how intense that situation was for the government of Mexico to try and rescue Evo Morales. Now, another note I want to make for you is that Evo Morales has done many things for Bolivia. He has, well, there's quite a list of the things he has done. He's made, I think, over 130 hospitals. Wow, there's a huge list. I would say that he is Bolivia's AMLO. He's done basically the same things, you know. They had a very high illiteracy in that country, and they brought it down to only 2.1 illiteracy. He's also done leaps and bounds with helping the elderly so that they qualify for government assistance, education, educational grants. He did thousands of co-ops, raised the minimum wage went up, I believe, 200% or something like that, a very high number. It might have even been more. I'll have to look that up. But I did have I do have a list that I'm going to be putting up and maybe discussing later. But he is as good for Bolivia as AMLO is for Mexico. And I think we need to help them. If there's any way that we can help them to keep their democracy, we need to do it. And I don't know why the U.S. isn't helping. There is a democracy that is being destroyed, and they're supposed to be protecting it. So, and they're supposed to be protecting human rights, and the people have an uprising against this military coup that has happened in Bolivia. And we need to pay attention, because it could happen to us. It could happen to everybody. And I don't know. You guys need to pay attention. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you were able to understand and that I did a good enough job interpreting. My pleasure. Have a great day. Oh, and by the way, like and subscribe. And if you haven't subscribed to RBC International, do so. And also, if you want to subscribe to AMLO Vision, I have a Spanish AMLO Vision for just basic AMLO topics. And then I have English AMLO Vision, which is the one where I translate AMLO topics to English. Thank you very much, and have a great day. Bye.